Hello, hello, I'm Li Hao. In this video, we are going to talk about bindings. What is binding? Well, we shall see. Let's take a look at one example that I prepared for you. So over here, we have an input and a variable called value. So this is a state where we can change the value of the value variable, and we show that value variable on the screen over here. So we add input events on the input so that we know whenever we type something like this, this will be called, and then we update the value of the value. So this will pass this value into the input itself so that it's updated, and also will show it on over here on the screen. So every time when you want to add event listeners from an input and then update a value of a variable, and then if you want to somehow change the value and then get it reflected onto the input. So when I say get it reflected is, what if I over here I have a button, and whenever I click on the button, I want to change the value to say ASDF, right? So I can type over here, every time I come over here, I change a variable called value and get it reflected. And I can do the other way around, which is I click me, update the value of the variable value, and then get it reflected on the input. So I click, you see it's updated to ASDF instead. So there's two ways of updating this variable value. One from the input event, or two is by just changing it directly. And this is a very common pattern that you would come out to control your inputs. And so Svelte comes up with a directive that handles this, so that you don't have to come over here, define an event listeners, define a variable. You have to define a variable, but like you can save time typing all this and just do this one thing instead, which is bind, the bind directive. That's why the title of this video, bindings, bind. And then I need to bind what? I need to bind the value of the input, right? So inputs.value is the value of the input. We read this value from here in this event, and then we pass this value in this variable. So this two way we want to read and write also, right? So we want the value property of this input, and bind with what? We're gonna bind it with a variable called value. So I'm gonna copy this variable and pass it in here. So I can remove all this at once. So this and this is the same. Binding is to receive an event listeners to get the value of this input and assign it to this variable called value. And also this is also doing this where whenever the value of the variable value has changed, we're gonna update the value property of this input. It's a bit mouthful, so let's try to change this. I'm gonna call this a foo instead, so that it's so that you can differentiate where this is, right? Okay, come up here. All right, so inputs, you read a property called value. Okay, you can't do this now. You read a property called value, and then over here you want into foo, and then you want to set foo into the value, the property called value. It's the same. This is the property name. This is a value. You read it to the variable called foo. And if we've changed foo, we want to update it back to the property called value. So I come over here, I can type. As you can see, this is this. I should comment this out. So only have this input that has bind. So when I type, it will get the value of the input. So this is no longer in use, right? Just so you know. Type value of the input. Value of the input comes to variable called foo, and so you see foo reflected over here. And if I click, okay, let me type more. And if I click on this button, I change the value of foo. It should update. So this foo variable should update the property called value. So there you go. So binding, we bind a variable, a property called value to the variable called foo, and it works two ways. It's a two-way data binding. Changing in the property will update the variable. Change in the variable will update the property. And And if your variable, instead of calling it foo, you call it value instead. Let's come back, value. Call it value instead, then you can have a shorthand, right? The property and the variable name is the same, then you can omit the whole thing. So this and the above is the same. Right, so I'm gonna change this so that you have a clear value. So this and this is the input bind value equals value, and bind value is exactly the same. So let's type and see a change. And you change, okay. And you click on, you update a variable called value, you update it back to your elements, property of the element. So there you go, binding on elements. Can't you do binding with components? Well, yes, you can as well. You can imagine instead of the attribute of the elements, you can change on the property of the component, the props of the component. And so I have a component called components. I'm going to import this over here. And in this component, I am going to use it over here and comment out everything that I'm not in use. So this component has a counter called count, and I have a button that just increments this count value. So to listen to this count changes, we maybe can add event listeners, and then so that I can update a variable over here. So I can come over here, have a variable called count, and I can so count equals count. Okay, so this is a short. I can do a shorthand count equals count. I can have a button that change this value. Whoops. Because 999. So I can have a button that updates the count value. And whenever I change, okay, I need to also have a event, right? So I come over here, dispatch count change. So I need to create. Import create event dispatcher from Svelte and create event dispatcher so every time count change I'll dispatch this count change event come over here wait should be on a component on count change I receive an event. Let me get it to a new line so that you can read it carefully clearer. Right, on count change you have event and the count will equal to event.detail. So over here you guys two things. Whenever we change inside, increment. I'm gonna name it differently. So if every time when you increment, this event will be called, and I need to come over here and show you that this value is updated. So every time it's called, I will get the latest value of the count, and it will be reflected on the screen over here. Right, and anytime. And when I click on this button, I want to update this value count to 999. So when I click this, it'll be 999 and this value will be passed in. So this count will be updated. So if I increment, yeah. And you get received over here. So it's kind of the same as your inputs where you events happening, you update a value. And if the value changes, you update the property of the attributes of the element. So I can do the binding for any props, in fact, any props. So this props is called count. So I can come over here and bind count to count. So I can comment. Okay. So this. Whoops. Let me comment this and just leave this for you. So bind count to count is again exactly the same as listened to the event, update the variable count, and whenever count change, update the props call count. Right, so this is the same as above. So I try over here, you see it's the same behavior. And in fact, since this variable and this property of the component is the same as the variable that we're going to assign to, we can use the binding shorthand. You can just write this increment and click me, increment, click me. So here you go, bindings for elements as well as components. So if you have any questions, ask in the comment section below. I will answer them. And if you like this video, give me a thumbs up. And remember to subscribe to my channel so that you get notified when the next one is out. So see ya. Bye-bye.